Hi, welcome to How to Repair. This video is the first in a series of videos that we're making on our European-made Thermosiphon solar water heating systems. Thermosolar is Europe's leading solar panel manufacturer. We will be making videos on how to assemble the unit, then we'll do a video on how to install the unit and commission it, followed by servicing and maintenance, and how to maximize the maximum efficiency out of your free solar energy. We are assembling the 150-litre system, which will be similar to the 300-litre system, which has a larger tank and two panels instead of one. Both systems come with full instruction manuals. The system is supplied to you as a complete kit for you to assemble on site. Two people can easily assemble this kit in approximately 30 minutes. The frame is made of high-quality galvanized steel. It is designed for a flat roof, but can either be modified for pitched roofs, or you could purchase a pitched roof kit frame. It is important to note that whether you're fitting this panel to a flat roof or to a pitched roof, the angle of the panel should be no less than 45 degrees, allowing it to recirculate correctly. Solar thermal systems work on the principle of heat rising and going through a heat exchanger inside the storage tank. This is a sealed system full of a glycol solution, which is heated by the sun inside the panel. The energy then rises into the tank, where the heat is transferred through the heat exchange unit into the fresh water storage tank, ready for use. As the tanks are very well insulated, the water can stay hot for 24 hours or more, depending on the climate that you live in. As you can see, the stand kit assembles very quickly and easily and has been tested to withstand extreme weather conditions. All the nuts and bolts are provided, apart from the fixings to your roof structure. As a cautionary note, I would always use some type of locking fluid on all the nuts and bolts once you have the frame in location, just to make sure they don't vibrate loose in extreme weather conditions, and should always be inspected at least once a year. Also remember, the 150-litre unit, when full of water, will weigh just over 300 kilos, so do make sure that your roof structure can handle that type of weight. Once the stand is installed, the panel then just clips into place, and you have two brackets, top and bottom, which hold the panel firmly in place. While we're installing this panel, do remember there are links on this video that will actually take you through to the website where you're able to get the full technical specifications on these products. There will also be links on here that will take you through to our tutorial section where you can find out how to get the best out of solar energy. These units can either be purchased directly from ourselves, but we will have to work out the shipping for direct delivery, or it is possible to pick them up from the distributor network that we have. We also have distributor installers who are able to fit the systems for you if you do not feel comfortable in assembling these and installing them yourself. Also, distributor inquiries are always welcome. We're just putting on the two retaining bands for the tank. This secures it in high wind conditions. Now, Chris, who's from the UK and a distributor and installer in the UK for Thermosolar, is going to show you the best ways of installing the system and doing all the plumbing joints. One of the things he has said to me is using the old-fashioned hempen paste on the threads is much better than using PTFE tape. It handles the temperatures much better, as the hot water side from the panel can get to some extreme temperatures. These systems have a life expectancy well in excess of 25 years if maintained correctly, which you can see in our other videos. The solar panels themselves have four tubes coming out of them. This is so you can join panels together. But on the single 150-litre unit, we are going to be blanking one, using one as a drain-off. One will be the hot feed going to the tank, and the other will be the return. It is important to use the reinforcing inserts on the copper pipes on the solar panel. This will protect them when the compression fittings are being done up, and no damage can ever occur to the actual copper pipe. Next, we're going to install the return pipe, which fits to the bottom of the right-hand side of this panel. Make sure you use the gaskets that are provided, as these are designed to handle high temperatures. Now we'll connect the pipe to the bottom of the tank. As you can see, the pipe is insulated. This is so it doesn't lose any of its energy on the return or feed to the tank. Again, fitting the gasket. Just fit the elbow in first. We'll nip it up in a second. Now, removing the transit cover, inserting the reinforcing insert. Just slot the nut and then the olive on. And now we're ready to nip this up. Once the tank has been commissioned, it's worth going round the joints just to make sure you haven't got any leaks. But you'll soon know once the solar panel itself starts to create heat and create pressure within the system. And we'll just put some cable ties around the pipe and onto the panel. This will stop it flapping in any high winds. Now we'll connect the hot water side out of the solar panel, going into the heat exchanger at the top of the tank. Again, using hemp and paste on these joints. As Chris said, it's much better than using PTFE. To give you a better idea how the system works, the glycol solution rises through the panel naturally as it warms up, then enters the tank here on this joint at the top. And as it cools through the exchange process, it then re-enters the bottom of the panel and starts the circulation process again. So we just need to nip this pipe up, remembering to keep it facing downwards towards the actual panel connector. Again, putting the reinforcing sleeve in. And now we can connect up the pipe. In our other videos, I will be explaining how solar water can actually reduce your electrical bills in your house and gas bills as well, by having pre-fed hot water going to appliances set at certain temperatures. I'll be explaining all this in our future videos and doing tests on individual machines. So not only will you get free hot water for the next 25 years minimum, you will also be saving on electrical bills and gas bills as well, but I'll put all this on the website for you. Now, on the last connection of the tank, we're actually going to fit a drain off valve. This is for us to drain off the glycol solution every 3 to 5 years, which is part of the maintenance program, as glycol can deteriorate over a period of time. Glycol is actually used in the system to stop the panel freezing in extreme winter conditions. Next, we're going to fit an expansion tank to the top left-hand side. This is fitted to absorb the pressure of the water as it heats up. Now, there is also a safety valve which is going to be fitted to the other side. If for any reason the expansion vessel is unable to cushion the amount of pressure, the safety valve, which will be fitted to the right-hand side, would automatically blow. This is basically the same principle as a standard pressure cooker you would have in your house. If the water got too hot and the pressure too great, the safety valve would just blow. In our next video on commissioning the unit and installing it on location, I will show you how to fill the glycol system. Also, how to connect the hot water to the house, including the hot water blow-off valve, and how to get the best out of your solar hot water. Again, using hemp and paste on this top joint, and just fitting the blow-off valve. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us. Thank you very much indeed for watching this video. And any inquiries on solar systems, please feel free to use the website. Thanks very much indeed for watching.